BTW presents Sesame Street, show 2082, produced at Reese Teletape, New York City.
Hello, forgetful.
Maynard.
Forgetful.
You rang?
My name is not Maynard. My name is Olivia, and I wish you'd call me by my name.
Oh, I'm sorry. Excuse me. I forgot.
I know you always forget.
Well, I'd call you by your name if I could only remember it.
Tell you what I'm going to do. I'm going to teach you a way that you will always remember my name. You'll always know it.
You wouldn't.
I will, because I love you, and I will.
Oh, thank you, thank you, thank you.
All right, now. Okay. First of all, you have to remember three things.
Okay, I'll do that.
They're not hard. They're not hard.
Okay.
First of all, olive.
Olive.
Yes. Now, an olive is something you eat. It's a little brown or green salty thing with a pit in it.
Oh, one of the things about like this, say, yes. Whoa, hey.
Uh-huh. Olive.
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 All right.
That's easy.
Okay. Now, the second thing is when you get frightened and you go, ee! If something scares you.
Oh, you mean like if a little mouth goes, and you go, ee! Like that?
Yes. So,
ee! Ee!
Ee!
Ee!
Good.
Oh, this is fun.
All right. Yeah. Now, the last thing
is
when you go, you know, when you're trying to remember something?
I am an expert at that.
I know you are.
All
right. Now, we put them all together, and we say.
Like that, see?
Yes. Olive.
Olive.
E.
E.
Ah.
Ah.
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 Olive.
E. Ah.
Olive.
E. Ah. Olivia. Olivia. Thank you. Thank you.
Yes. Now, so all you have to do is remember that it's something you eat.
Something you eat.
Something you scream.
Something you scream.
Something you say when you can't remember.
Something you scream.
Something you eat.
Something you eat.
Something you scream.
Something you scream.
Something you say when you can't remember.
Something you
eat.
Something you scream.
Something you say when you can't remember.
Something you eat.
Something you scream.
Something you say when you can't remember.
Something you eat.
I got it.
Okay.
It's something you eat.
Yes.
Something you scream.
Yes.
And something you say when you can't remember.
Yes. Now what is my name?
Is Potato Chips Wahoo.
You know, I've tried. I've really tried.
Was that wrong?
Just call me Fred.
Okay, Fred.
Roses are red. Violets are blue. Sugar is sweet. And so are you. Hello, Cookie Monster here. Today, me going to see what shape is best for cookies. Okay, see these cookies here, over here, they're all different shapes. And me going to see now. This one here, this whole pile here, they square-shaped cookies. See the square? Yeah. You know why they square? They have four sides that all the same and four corners that all the same. And that makes square. Okay. That square-shaped pile of cookies. This here, these cookies, not square-shaped like those, these triangle-shaped cookies. And you know why they're called triangles? Because these have three sides, three, and three corners or points, as some people call them. Okay, so much for triangle-shaped cookies. Ooh, they look nice. Okay, and this here, this is traditional cookie, this circle-shaped cookie. And circles don't have any sides. Okay, now let me put that down. Aha! Now, Cookie Monster going to test to find out which shape best for cookie taste. Aha, and know what kind of test? What kind of test is a taste test? Oh, me love this test. Okay. Now, me start with the square-shaped cookie. Good texture. Delicate aroma. Cotton throat. Now, triangle. Triangle-shaped cookie. Yes, right. Good. Obviously vintage. Now, a circle-shaped cookie. This one should be the best. It's classic. Well, that's pretty good. Me still not make decision. Well, got to keep taste testing. It's right square. Good to triangle. Circle. No cookies. Well, after much thought, me arrive at decision. Me know which shape me like best for cookies. Tummy shaped. Me got tummy ache. Bye-bye, crumbs.
Say, that's a beautiful D you're building there.
Sure is, isn't it? Look at that nice straight back. And how about this curved front here, huh? Fits perfectly to the back. Okay, boys, take it away.
What are you going to do with this D?
Why, this is the D building here. It's full of everything in the world that begins with the letter D. Here, this floor here is the doll floor. They've already moved some dolls in, I see.
Yes, doll begins with D, doesn't it?
And here's the dog floor. Boy, listen to him bark. D-O-G spells dog, all right.
And this must be the floor with diamonds. Aren't they beautiful?
Wow. Hold your ears. Here's the drum floor.
Drum begins with D, too.
And here's where the ducks and dinosaurs and desks will be, on these floors here. Here we are.
Wait. I know a word that begins with D that you forgot to put in your building.
Oh.
Oh, hi. I'm waiting for Mr. Snuffleupagus. He's going to knock on my door with a new secret knock. It goes like this. See? Now, when I hear that knock on the door, I'll know that it's Mr. Snuffleupagus. And you'll know it, too, because I told you the secret knock is like this. And the best part is, I told Gordon and Olivia to come over here to hear something, and they'll get a big surprise. And when they hear this knock, and I open the door, they'll see, you know who, Mr. Snuffleupagus. I can't wait. Oh, well, we know that, this sound, you hear that knock? It's not. is it? No, it has to be somebody else. Come in!
Hello,
hi, Olivia.
Bird. How are you?
Hello.
Listen, well, I'm ready to hear what I'm supposed to hear and be surprised.
Okay, you're gonna hear... like that.
I'm going to hear...
That's right, but on my door.
Oh, on the door, okay. Well, what's the surprise?
Well, if I told you, it wouldn't be a surprise. Would you mind sitting right here, Olivia?
No, no.
Okay.
No, I
don't
mind. Oh, is that it?
Well, of course not, Olivia. That wasn't...
Oh, sorry.
Was it? Now, lost my head. Come in.
Hello.
Hello.
Hi, Gordon.
Come on in.
Well, okay. What am I supposed to hear?
Oh. That.
Dun, 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 dun.
Yes, but on my front door.
Oh.
And then comes the surprise.
Oh, well, what's the surprise?
Oh, I can't tell you. I'd spoil it. Why don't you have a seat?
Oh. Okay.
You just wait,
just
wait a little bit.
Okay,
it won't
sure.
be long.
All right.
We'll just wait, and the surprise will come.
Big Bird, we really have to be moving along.
Dun, 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 dun. When will it happen?
Oh, any second now.
Oh, any second. Oh, okay.
Yep. Guess this is pretty exciting for you guys, huh?
Oh,
yeah, sure.
Yep.
Well, I guess I'd better be moseying along.
No.
Yeah, me too.
Did you hear that?
Yes. There it is.
That's it.
Excuse me?
Oh, okay.
Olivia?
Okay.
Gordon? I would like you all to meet, ta-da, Mr. Snuffleupagus.
Snuffy told me a knock like that and tell you he would be late for Snuffle Garden, and he'll try tomorrow.
Oh, he won't be here, huh, Sky?
Mm-mm.
Oh, thanks.
Well, we did hear the knock.
Yes, right? Yes, yeah. And we were surprised.
Oh, very, very surprised. Yes. Yes.
So was
thank
I,
you.
Unfortunately.
Oh, yes.
Okay.
Well,
yeah.
Listen,
bye.
You know the secret knock now.
Come
back tomorrow.
Yeah, I can't wait.
Oh, good. Slowly, we're getting somewhere.
One more time. Now you try it.
La 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 la.
My, but it is certainly wonderful of you to invite me over to sleep over at your house tonight.
Oh, yeah, well, think nothing of it. It's our pleasure,
Kelt. Sure, sure, you're the guest.
But I do feel bad taking Bert's bed.
Oh, don't feel bad about that.
No, no, Bert doesn't mind.
No. See, I got my blanket and my pillow right here. I'll
well,
just go
if
sleep.
You're sure.
I'll just go sleep on the couch in the inside room there, okay?
Sure, the couch is comfortable, Kelt.
Yeah, it is, okay?
Mm-hmm.
Bye-bye now.
Have
okay. a good
Betty
sleep.
Bye.
You
yeah, sleep,
too.
Sleep
pleasant
tight, Bert.
I will, bye-bye.
Okay.
Yes. And so to bed.
Yes, boy, am I sleepy. I'll tell you one thing. I am sure going to sleep tonight, Kelt, because I am so sleepy.
Well,
sleep tight.
Good night, Ernie, my friend.
Good night.
I am worried only about one thing.
What's that?
Me. I'm not sleepy at all.
Oh, yeah? Oh, well, that's no problem. You know, whenever I'm not sleepy, Bert tells me to count sheep.
Count sheep? Who is that?
It's not a who, it's a what. It's what you do when you can't sleep, you see.
I never heard of doing that when you're trying to go to sleep, but it sounds extremely interesting.
Oh, sure. See, all you do is you start imagining sheep, you know, jumping over a fence or something like that, and you start counting them. And before you know it, you get so sleepy from all that counting that you just drop right off asleep, you see?
Sounds perfect.
Mm-hmm.
I'll try it. Thank you so much.
Okay. Good night now.
Good night, Ernie. Now, if I'm going to count sheep jumping over a fence, first I need a fence. There. One cute little fence. And now for the sheep. One cute little woolly sheep jumping the fence. Two cute little sheep jumping the fence. Three 3 little sheep jumping the fence. 4 little sheep jumping the fence. 5 little sheep jumping the fence. 6 little sheep jumping the fence. Oh, I love these. 7 little sheep jumping the fence. 8 little sheep jumping the fence. Oh, this is wonderful. 9 sheep jumping the fence. 10 sheep jumping the fence.
Please be quiet.
That owl should get up. It's a beautiful day. He should be flying around like me. Can't you be quiet? I'm trying to sleep. It's nighttime. Everybody sleeps at night.
Not everybody sleeps at night. We owls stay up at night and sleep in the daytime. It's always been that way with owls.
Really? That's strange.
It's not strange. It's just different. I'll tell you what, Bluebird. Since we have to share this tree, I'll try not to wake you up at night, and you try not to wake me up in the morning.
That's a very good idea.
Good night, Bluebird.
Good night, Owl.
This couch is pretty comfortable after all. Yeah. Well, I had a good night's sleep. I wonder if the Count slept well.
Good morning, Bert. Good morning. A wonderful day.
Good morning, Count. You seem so bright and chipper. Hey, did you have a good night?
A good night? I had the most wonderful night I've ever had.
Wow. Hey, that's good. I'm so glad. You know, it makes me so happy to know that you slept well. Yeah.
Slept? Who slept?
43,893.
Could I sleep over again tonight, Bert?
Dog. There once was a hound dog called Fred, who loved to stand on his head. He wriggled his toes and wrinkled his nose. And until he was fed. The dog.
I bet you don't know how to make Chinese noodles. I do. My father makes them in his factory. First, he puts flour and salt and water and mixes them all up in this machine. Then, he puts all the stuff in the kneader. That's this machine. And he rolls it and makes it soft. And it makes it all stick together. Then it gets put in this machine. And it gets rolled thinner. And thinner. And longer. Longer and thinner. Then it gets ready for the very last machine. Way they make Chinese noodles, and here's the way they eat them. Chinese noodles, they're my very best favorite food.
This is a cuckoo clock. It's called that because every hour a cuckoo bird comes out of this little door and tells you what time it is. Like now it's almost 3 o'clock, so very soon the little cuckoo bird will say cuckoo 3 times.
Excuse me, Mac.
Sorry.
Just step aside there.
Whoopsie daisy. Thanks, pal.
Hey, watch your toes
there.
Come
on, sorry.
Excuse me, Mac.
Cuckoo.
That's one.
Cuckoo.
Two.
Cuckoo.
Three.
Sorry. Come on. Hey, look out.
See you in an hour.
3 cuckoo birds.
Hey, this is Bushman Bill with a big hit song you've all been waiting for. That's right, boys and girls. And Bushman Bill played it first right here. The numero uno tune on the hit parade this week. DDO Day and the Dewdrops and Be My D. Remember, you heard it right here with Bushman Bill. Now, back to your regularly scheduled kiddie show.
Ladies and gentlemen, the teeny little super guy.
Teeny little super guy pops right up before your eye. He's no bigger than your thumb.
Snap your fingers, here I come. Now stop me if you've heard this one.
Don't look in the sky, don't look in the sea. He's inside of you and me.
Did I ever tell you about the time?
You can't tell a hero by his side.
I'm just a teeny little super guy. A long time ago, when I was just as old as you are now, I couldn't read words. I just didn't know what words meant. Take this one, for instance. I know now that the word is danger. See? Danger. But when I was a little teeny, teeny little super guy, I just didn't know. Seems like every place I'd go when I was a youngster, I'd see this word. Oh, whoa! That was a close call. I could have been hurt. Here's that word again. I wonder what it means. Is it hot in here or is it just me? Well, luckily I learned what the word means. It's danger. Danger. And when you see it, it means get away from where you are because something bad might happen to you. Oh, mercy. Do I make my point?
You can't tell a hero by his side.
I'm just a teeny little super guy. Oh, yeah.
Thank you.
River, run to the sea. Salmon, run to the sea. If you need someone, you can run to me. Flowers grow to the sun, shines on everyone. If you've lost the warmth, I will give you some. Lay back on a starry night, feel as big and as small as you are. Well, I see who you are, and I like what I see. If you wanna be, you can be with me. Lay back on a starry night. Feel as big and as small as you are. Well, I see who you are, and I like what I see. If you wanna be, you can be with me. Well, if you wanna be, you can be with me. Oh, if you wanna be, you can be with me.
This is Carlene. She lives in Arizona. She is in the first grade in school. They are writing the word tomato and coloring a picture of it. After school, she goes to the river with her friends. Quite a while to get dry. Carlene goes home for supper.
Would you like to hear a story right now? Well, this is the story of good King Digitus and how his kingdom of addition became the kingdom of subtraction. King Digitus and his loyal subjects loved to add. They added anything they could get their hands on.
Let's see. Well, two pigs plus one pig equals three pigs. There are three pigs in the kingdom. Is there another loyal subject with something to add?
I have three pizzas, Your Majesty.
Wonderful.
And I have one pizza, Your Kingliness.
All right, well, let's see. One, two, three pizzas plus one pizza is 3 plus 1 is Four pizzas! I just love addition. Adding is so much fun. What shall we add next?
I say, let's add hats.
Hats it shall be.
Yes.
Your Majesty.
Yes?
We added hats last Tuesday.
Oh, drat.
Oh, well, let's see. Have we added lips yet?
We've done lips, Your Majesty.
Oh, well, how about pineapples? Have we added pineapples?
Done.
Well, kittens, kites, cantaloupes?
Done.
Oh, no. Is there nothing left to add in the entire kingdom?
Oh, alas.
Oh,
whoa, what shall we ever do?
Oh.
Yes, the day finally came when everything had been added up. There was nothing left to add in the entire kingdom. Good King Digitus didn't know what to do.
Oh, whoa. I don't know what to do. There's nothing left to add. We'll have to just close down the entire kingdom.
Oh, no.
Oh, Your Highness.
Yeah, well, what is it, kid?
If there's nothing left to add, why don't we subtract?
Subtract?
Uh-huh.
I say, what is subtraction?
I don't know. Does it hurt?
Sounds radical.
Ridiculous! This is the kingdom of addition!
Mm, yeah. Well, now, hold on. Let's give the kid a chance. Now, how does this subtraction go, anyhow?
Like this. If I have three pizzas, and I take away one pizza...
Look at that!
That leaves two pizzas. And if I have two, and I take away one... That leaves one!
My goodness!
And if there's one left, and I take away one... Nothing.
Remarkable.
Oh, I think you're onto something, kid. I think I like subtraction as much as I like addition. I think from this day forth, this shall be known as the kingdom of subtraction.
I say, why don't we subtract chairs?
But Your Majesty, yours is the only chair in the kingdom.
Oh, that's a good idea. One chair, take away one chair, leaves...
Careful.
That's the door,
Now, one chair,
yeah.
Take away one chair,
yeah.
Is no chair!
And so...
We're not going to subtract chairs anymore.
Excuse me, Your Highness, but... did you know that you don't have to throw anything when you subtract?
You don't?
Nope.
Oh. Hey, you don't have to throw anything when you subtract!
And so the Kingdom of Addition became known as the Kingdom of Subtraction. And they all lived happily ever after. The end.
Okay,
draw a circle.
A half a circle.
No, more.
Around
that right there.
No.
Bring it up a little bit.
The bottom one a little bit further.
Oh, stop.
Now make a line across it.
No.
Across
right,
the you
no, right where the right where you ended at. Make a line across. Yeah.
What is it?
A G.
The letter G.
In the wintertime, the woods are very quiet. And the animals, they hibernate. Bears, skunks, chipmunks, they go to sleep. All through the cold winter months. There's no leaves on the trees in wintertime. Lots of birds go down south at wintertime where it's warm. I like to look for deer tracks. It's very hard for deer to find food in the wintertime. The deers come and eat apples off our apple tree. It's rainy in the springtime. All the snow melts. The water runs into the ground. The streams fill full of water, and the trees drink their water through the roots, and all the leaves grow back on. Geese and the ducks, all the birds come back. And all the animals wake up. The leaves, the grass, everything turns to green. The flowers all grow. Red, purple, pink. I love the smell of flowers. And best of all, I like to run through the fields.
Mouth.
I'm missing.
Missing.
Something missing. What missing?
Ananas.
I don't know. Nose! That's it?
Nose missing.
Oh, I don't know. Nose missing. Where nose?
I have nose.
Right, where my nose?
No, one nose.
No, give me no. No, give me my nose.
Just one nose.
What? Okay.
One.
My nose.
No.
What?
My nose.
No, my nose.
No, my nose.
No, my nose.
No, mine.
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 No.
Broken.
Broken. Broken. Broken. Broken. Broken. Broken.
Wait.
Broken.
Broken? One.
Two.
Two noses!
Carrot!
Nose!
Whoop! Right.
Whoa, you got nose?
Nose.
This a nice...
Nose easy.
Nose.
Easy.
Easy.
Yeah.
Good.
Yeah.
Two noses!
Yeah.
Good two-headed snowman! Cold. Hot chocolate?
Hot chocolate. Yeah.
Bye bye.
Bye bye, snowman.
Bye bye.
Noisy. Quiet. Noisy.
Let's see now, what do we have here? We have sausage and peppers, hoagies and subs, sliced pizza, calzone, cheese and ham, and soft drinks. Well, I'm gonna get myself a nice slice of pizza because there is nothing like a nice, warm, crispy slice of nice, warm pizza with lots of cheese on a cold, rainy day like today.
Hey, wait, hey, Skinny. Hey, look, you're going in there to get a pizza, huh?
Yes, Oscar.
Well, order one for me. Here's the money. Huh?
All right, Oscar. What do you want on it?
Oh, well, the usual. You know, green peppers, red peppers, pepperoni, peanut butter, crunchy, mustard, maraschino cherries, shredded wheat, gravy, and some chocolate mint ice cream on top. And hold the mayo. What are you going to have?
Nothing, Oscar. I've lost my appetite.
What do you suppose came over her?
In a pretty little house made of
celery. There lives a little kitty cat family. One, two, three. They can make their tails look just like spaghetti, and they dine in bed on apple brown Betty. One, two, three. But these pretty kitties, they're great circulators. They know a pretty fish, and they're friends with alligators. One, two, three. And when the sun decides to go out of sight, the pretty little kitties stand and wave goodnight. One, two, three.
Love can keep you afloat. You're a guy or a girl or a goat who's in love and afloat on a float. If I can't sing this
song. Hi there, seagull. Oh, wow. You know what I love? I love this boat. I really do. I really love this boat. I mean, if you're going to talk about something that I love, then let's talk about this boat. Because no greater love hath any person for any boat than I have for this boat here. Whoa!
Good morning, Ernest.
Oh, good morning, Amanda. Do you know what I love?
Oh, what do you love, Ernest?
Amanda.
Yes?
I love.
Yes?
I love this boat.
Oh.
I really do really love this boat.
Oh. Mm. Oh, well, I love this boat, too.
You do?
Oh, yes. I adore this boat.
Oh.
I am crazy about this boat.
Oh, good.
In fact, my cup runneth over with love for this boat.
Oh, wow, yes.
Oh. Oh, I love it.
Oh, sir. Oh, sir.
Yes?
Do you know what we love?
Oh, yes. I know.
You do?
I know. You love this boat.
Yes.
And you love this boat.
Yes.
You both love this boat.
Yes, we do.
Oh, you love this boat so much it's coming out of my ears.
Yes.
And you want to know something?
What?
Do you want to know something?
What?
I love this boat, too.
Oh,
you do?
Yes.
Wow.
Oh,
we all love this
yes,
boat.
Love it.
Hi, fish.
Hey, you know what? I love this boat, too.
Oh, I love
it. Hey, everybody.
What?
Everybody, you know what we love?
What?
Huh? We love this boat.
Right. Oh, I love this boat.
Here comes King Minos. All listen and hear how whatever he touches will poof, disappear. Just a touch of his finger brings forth this reaction. He makes things go away. It's like magic subtraction. One day, while out riding, he glanced up above at a maid in a castle, and his heart filled with love. But outside awaited a terrible fate. There were four awful dragons guarding the gate. One tried to fry him and chortled with glee, but King Minos touched him. And then there were three. Four take away one, leaves three. Another fierce dragon leaped into view. King Minos touched him. And then there were two. Three take away one, leaves two. Along came another jumping high as the sun. The king took him away. And then there was one. Two take away one, leaves one. The last dragon thought that to hide would be best, for he saw what had happened to all of the rest. So into the forest he started to run, but King Minos found him. And then there were none. One take away one leaves none. Then he rode in the castle and out on the roof. When he touched the fair maiden, alas, she too went poof.
One of these things is not like the others. Which one is different, do you know? Tell me which thing is not like the other, and I'll tell you if it is so. Okay, let's see what we got here. We got three dancing people, and we got one dancing worm. So if you guess the dancing worm doesn't belong, you're absolutely right. So come on, Slimy, get out of there. You're too good for that yucky bunch. Okay, guys, just eat your hearts out.
1, 2, 3, 1, 2, 3, 1, 2, 3, count. 1, 2, 3, 1, 2, 3, 1, 2, 3, count. 3 is my favorite number. 3 sets my head in a spin. I'm in ecstasy, waltzing my 1, 2, 3. Please let the music begin. 3 is my favorite number. 3 makes me glad, can't you see? When I'm dancing triple, each 1, 2, 3 skip will be showing how grand it could be. If you'd 1, 2, 3, 1, 2, 3, keep counting. 1, 2, 3, 1, 2, 3, keep counting. 1, 2, 3, 1, 2, 3, keep counting with me. Count!
Snuffy!
Oh, hello, Bert. What do you think of my costume?
Gee, what are you supposed to be? An inside-out Oreo cookie?
Oh, no, Bert.
Then what?
I'm a cloud.
Oh, I should have known.
We're doing a play in Snuffle Garden today about the sky.
Gee, do you have cloud things to say in it?
Oh, better than that, Bert. I get to sing a cloud song. Wanna hear it?
Oh, sure. I never heard a cloud sing. Lay it on me, Snuff.
Okay, Bert, but you have to imagine that I'm floating in the sky.
Okay, I'm imagining.
I wish I was a cloud, away up in the blue. I'd float across the sky just looking for you. And if I saw you walking down below, with a little drop of rain, I'd say hello. And if it got too hot, I'd shade you. I wouldn't let the sunshine fade you. And if I saw you go to sleep at night, I'd cover up the moon to turn out the light. A cloud away up in the blue, I'd sail along the breeze just following you. And if you ever looked above you, I'd try to spell I love you. If I was a cloud in the sky up high, if I was a cloud in the sky, oh my. If I was a cloud in the sky, and if you ever looked above you, I'd try to spell I love you. If I was a cloud in the sky.
Oh, Snuffy! Say, that was really wonderful, Snuff.
Oh, thanks, Bird. When I wrote it, I was thinking of you.
Oh, well, you know, clouds and birds are close friends.
Thank you.
I'm Captain Breakfast, and it's my job to make sure kids eat a healthy, wholesome breakfast.
I don't want any breakfast.
Oh, this is a job for Captain Breakfast! Hi there, kid. I'm Captain Breakfast.
I don't want any breakfast.
Oh, little girl, did you know breakfast is one of the most important meals of the day? It gives you energy all day long and makes you feel healthy and strong.
I don't want any breakfast.
Well, this is a little harder than I thought, but get a load of this. It works every time. Little girl, how would you like a tall, frosty glass of thirst-quenching orange juice? No. Well, how about a crunchy bowl of cereal with fresh milk and fresh fruit? No, how about a poached egg with jam and toast? Well, how about a stack of wheat cakes? A toasted English? Well, farina then!
I don't want any breakfast.
You keep saying that. Think of my reputation. Well, why don't you want any breakfast, little girl?
Because it's time for lunch.
Well, I never.
One, two, three.
just be floating along.
Oh, must you? Well, I love your cloud costume, Snuff.
Oh, thanks. Bye, Bird.
Bye-bye, Snuff. You're gonna be a smash in that play.
What are you yelling at?
Hey, Bird.
Oh,
what's all the noise?
Sorry, but I was just calling to say goodbye to my friend, Mr. Snuffleupagus. Gee,
oh?
It's too bad, because you just missed him.
Huh. Well, what else is new?
Well, what's new? Why, today, Snuffy was a cloud.
Mr. Snuffleupagus was a cloud?
Oh, sure.
Oh, Big Bird.
Yeah, and he sang a cloud song. And he was floating through the air and... Well, maybe you had to be there.
Yeah.
Yeah.
But still, he was wearing a tutu.
Sesame Street has been brought to you today by the letters D and G and by the number 3. Sesame Street is a production of the Children's Television Workshop.